welcome to this week's episode. So this week we're going to talk about some steps I want to give you to have an easy and quick newborn session from start to finish. Step number one is prepping your clients. It is so important to prep your clients. Now, usually when clients do book you in, it takes a few times to send them the same information until it actually sinks in. Now, by that I mean, you know, sometimes we get sent information, we just go through it a little bit, but we don't pay attention to all the details. And you know, with a newborn, a client is sitting at home with their newborn, breastfeeding, trying to book this and that and appointments. The last thing they want to do is be sitting there reading your newborn session guide, or you know your information that you sent to them. So you want to be very specific and clear. What I do when I prep my clients, my emails are pretty much listed out as dot points. So I list for them what to bring, the essentials, what to expect, how to arrive on time, and you know, all the important information. And yes, I do have a booklet that I send to them. It's an actual PDF where it welcomes them, and it's an actual session guide of what to expect, what to bring, what to wear, if they have children, any siblings, things like that. But I know they probably won't open that and go through it because it's a few pages of detailed stuff. But I gather all the important details and I pop them in an email. We even send it in the reminder and confirmation email just a day before their session so they can have a quick rundown, and that way you've done your job by preparing your clients. So I really think that prepping your clients will definitely save you and help your clients feel more comfortable coming into your session. Step number two is prepping this session before the clients arrive to your studio. So by that I mean having your props nicely set up with the backdrop, with your wrap, with anything that you're going to actually photograph. So having that all set up. Now I do 2 to 3 setups, and I have that set up in my studio side by side. So once the client comes in, we get started straight away into the session with no delays. I like to do that, and that's what's actually helped me, you know, make my sessions go longer. It used to take me 3 or 4 hours. Now, with even an ordering session right after their actual, you know, session when I photograph them, it literally takes me a maximum of 1.5 hours. So step number three is getting right into it. Now, I talked about this in step number two slightly towards the end. By that I mean is actually when the clients come into your studio or you go to the client's home, you get straight into shooting and photographing your, you know, your subjects. So if you do family shots and you've got an outdoor session, once you arrive at the location, you get started straight away. So you instruct your clients, okay, you know, obviously you say hello and you welcome them, but you tell them, all right, so we're gonna start off with photographing mum and dad, and then we get the kids in, or we photograph the kids first. So with newborn sessions, when the clients come in, I pretty much welcome them in, get them comfortable sitting down, and tell them, all right, how's the baby feeling? Has the baby fed? When did the baby sleep last? I understand that information, and I tell them, if you don't mind, can we undress the baby while I quickly set up? While they're undressing the baby, I get my camera nice and ready, and then we get straight into the session, no delays. Step number four is to create automated emails to send to your clients, especially after your session. Now, by this I mean, if you probably experienced this, once clients leave, they either text you or email you like an hour, a few hours later, or that night, or the next day, or a few days later, asking where their images are because they're so excited, they want to see them. We do get a lot of clients like that in my studio, and that's okay. They're just excited, they want to see the final results and things like that. So what I do this to save my sanity and to save my assistants time and effort is we automate these emails. So what happens is we have 3 or 4 emails that get sent out to our clients right after their session, and we call this a series of emails our after session workflow emails. And there are 3 or 4 emails, so once they leave, my assistant knows and she activates those series of emails, and they get sent to them, you know, they could be days apart. Some of them include like thanking them coming to their session, we really enjoyed having them. Another email might include, because we give them a time frame of when the gallery, their gallery will be ready to come in and pick up and take home. So I give them about 2 weeks. So during that, after the first week, there's an email that goes out and tells them your gallery's in line to be edited. Once it's edited, we will email you. So instead of having them bombard us with emails, we actually update them during those series of emails we send to them, which we call the after session email workflow. So that's it for this week's episode. Remember, if you haven't already, head on over to thephotographersociety.com and make sure to download my free newborn session guide. So many people are loving it. So if you haven't got a copy, it's absolutely free. Go download it. And if you haven't been following me on Instagram, make sure you go and follow me there. That's where I'm usually always active. So head on over and follow me at Photography by Rochelle. If you have any questions, remember again to leave them below, and I'll catch you all next week. Instagram, so make sure you head on over there.